Happy Friday, ClassPad fans. It's Statistics Friday, and here I'm going to talk to you about dot plots, and we're going to draw a couple of comparative dot plots and look at two related sets of data. So here you see that I've already created a statistics or a data sticky note just by clicking or tapping anywhere in Classpad.net and choosing the data sticky option here. And I've already pre-filled it with data to save us some time. All of this data is heights of students that was gathered from an activity from the American Statistical Association, a free lesson plan that's available online entitled If the Shoe Fits. The data in the left-hand column is data from a set of female students at a school, and the data in the right-hand column is data from a set of male students. This data was gathered from two different statistics classes combined. Let's say that we just want to make a dot plot in the first place. I'm going to select column A over here, and that will bring up my statistics soft menu here. I go to the second page of choices, which is where all of our plots are, and I'm going to choose dot plot. And there you can see I get a very nice dot plot. I can look at all of these points and see where they are. I can drag the dot plot around. And so you can see that I start to get some idea of the data's distribution. The typical advantages of a dot plot, given that being that each dot is representing a single data point. So every single piece of our data is represented. And then I'm going to select the data in column B. I'm going to drag to select that here just to show you another way to do it. And then I'm going to create another dot plot. Now, by default, the dot plots superimpose. So I see them both on the same graphing grid. And you can see that where we have red and blue intersecting, we get this nice purple effect, so you can see where dots are overlapping. But you may not want to look at the data on top of each other like this. I mean, we can kind of see that the blue data skews a little bit to the right with that fun statistical term that means all the dots are on the left. And you can see that the red data skews to the left because our red dots are on the right. I'm going to move this dot plot information down here, and I'm going to move the data sticky note down here, so that I can separate these two graphs. The reason I moved those is because if I attempt to separate and I drop this blue graph on top of anything that involves red data, it will leave them combined. So now you can see that this is actually the blue data has been separated. And now I can start to reorganize my screen the way that I want to. So if I want to say, hey, this is blue dot plot and this is red dot plot, and that's the data that it has to do with, I can do that. And I can now look at the dot plots side by side. So we can see the blue data and how it's distributed. We can see the red data and how it's distributed. And of course, if you wanted to look at these as box and whiskers, either separate or together, or you wanted to look at the one variable statistics or five number summary or any of those kinds of things, those are all also options that are available inside the statistics menu here. And you can learn about those in other videos.